How are you feeling in terms of what our public communication is at this point?
Which we could do, we should be doing more, I think.
What do you think we should be doing?
Well, I know that, you know, consistent with what you talked about at the deputy's meeting, I think we need to do more with the state.
Okay.
Our state, and particularly our state RSLOs, the regional state liaison officers.
Yep.
And I know that the chairman has talked to the other commissioners this afternoon. They briefly talked about that. But, yeah, we'll make sure that all the commission officers have what we prepare over the next day or so.
Thank you.
This is commercial news operation.
I believe so.
Okay. Okay, well, let's continue as frequently as is appropriate, and when we do have new information to update these reports, and I like the format that was in this last.
And you know what? If it does, if we end up with molten core, and then you talk about the time for the concrete, you know, to disassociate. It's, you know, that new reg says it's a couple inches an hour. You know, and of course that Mark I containment is the worst one of all the containments we have, and it's, you know, it's literally, you know, the new reg tells you that in a station blackout you're going to lose containment. You know, there's no doubt about it.
They are looking for insights, guidance, recommendations from the NRC for all four spent fuel pools for the Daiichi site, Daiichi site, the CHI site. They believe Daiichi site, yep, the CHI one.
Yep.
Unit 1 and 2 is boiling down, and Unit 3 and 4 is having, you know, zerk water reaction. They believe there is essentially no walls on Unit 3. The explosion, I'm sorry, Unit 4, the explosion leveled the walls, leveled the structure for the Unit 4 spent fuel pool all the way down to the approximate level of the bottom of the fuel, so there is no water in there whatsoever.
This is going to progress to the point at which we probably have, I think have to assume at this point that we're going to have three reactors out of control and possibly up to six spent fuel pools.
Agreed.
I think we need to take whatever actions are necessary to deal with that. That is the message I think we need to deliver to the ambassador as soon as possible. If that involves a general evacuation of U.S. citizens, we need to instruct that to be done immediately. Does anyone disagree with that?
Chairman, this is Admiral Donald of Naval Reactors. I agree with you.
For your background, other countries, I think right now what we're talking about is the status of U.S. personnel in Japan. Not necessarily, you know, evacuations outside of the, around the facility, et cetera. If we still believe that 50 miles is the appropriate distance, then we can also have that as a message. But I think there's broader U.S. personnel issues that need to be addressed.
Yeah, Chairman, this is Bill Borchardt. If this happened in the U.S., we'd go off the 50 miles. That would be our evacuation recommendation.
Greg, when you say it's only likely to get worse, not better, and thinking about the general evacuation of U.S. citizens in Japan, I ask once again, what do you see now as the worst scenario as far as what the impact could be on Japan?
At this point, I would see the worst scenario probably being three reactors eventually having, for lack of a better term, a meltdown. So the reactors would likely eventually breach primary containment and have some type of release. Again, it's difficult to predict the magnitude of that release, coupled with potentially up to six spent fuel pools in a degraded condition, possibly with spent fuel pool fires. Those are all significant events.
It's progressed to at least two reactors, multiple spent fuel pools, and maybe four reactors and four spent fuel pools. So,
right.
You know. You know, that condition has changed.
Clarity on that. It's our understanding, I think, that the fourth reactor has been defueled, so it's a spent fuel pool, unit 4, that's the biggest problem.
Yeah, and then they lost geometry on that.
Right.